Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Michelle Foray. I'm a fourth grade teacher in Maryland and I'm also my school's e-coach, which means I help teachers integrate educational technology in their classrooms. For today's episode of EdTech Made Easy, I wanted to share a fantastic free website called Classroom Screen that merges a ton of instructional tools such as timers, directions, and more. Let's jump right into it. The website URL is classroomscreen.com, which will be linked down in the description box. And I do recommend accessing the website through Google Chrome because it seems to work best with that browser. This website is made to be projected onto your board and viewed by your students during class. However, keep in mind that at this time, there is no option for saving your screen. I hope in the future, the website will add a login feature where you can save your screen, but for now, that is not possible. However, you can load your entire screen in a matter of seconds using this website. I'm going to start by reviewing the various widgets that are available in the bottom toolbar. First, there is the language widget. You are able to select different languages, and I will say that the selection of languages is very impressive. Next is the background widget. Once you access the website, it will automatically choose a background for you, but you are able to customize the background. There are 35 preloaded background images and 8 solid background colors you can use. There are also 7 GIFs or GIFs, however you want to pronounce it, because I know how angry people get about that. These are my personal favorite, especially the fire, the beach, and the waterfall, because I feel like they are super calming for students. You also have the option to upload your own image, or you can have the background be a live feed of an attached webcam. I personally have never used that function, but it is there if you can think of a creative way to use it. The next widget is for selecting random names. Once you type in all of your student names, you can actually save it as a text file and then upload it the next time you use the screen, so you don't have to retype the names every time. This is a great tool for randomly selecting students to participate in class or in activities. You can also choose a random dice roller and you can select between 1, 2, or 3 dice. There is a sound effect that goes with it, but you could always mute your sound if it bothers you, because I will say it gets annoying pretty quickly. You can move the widget around the screen by clicking and dragging in the top right corner, and this widget does give you the option to add another random name picker to the screen by clicking the yellow +1 button on the widget. This can be useful if you have 2 different groups of students for an activity. However, the most you can have is 2. So if you have more than 2 groups, you wouldn't be able to have a separate name picker for each group. To remove the widget from the screen, you can just click the red X and it will disappear. Once you add names or upload a list of names to the random name picker once, they will stay loaded in the widget until you exit or refresh the website. The next widget is for sound level. For this widget to work, you do have to have some sort of mic connected, and you have to give the website permission to access your mic. I personally am unable to use this widget in my classroom because I do not have a mic set up. However, the sound level widget is a great way to manage noise control in your classroom. You can adjust the level of acceptable sound using the left and right arrows, and you can adjust the level of sensitivity. You will notice that the bar stays green when it is below the level of acceptable sound, but turns red once it passes that level. You can choose to have a bell ding when it passes that level, or you can keep it silent. This is a great visual and auditory reminder of acceptable noise level for students as they are working in partners or small groups. The next widget displays a QR code for a URL that you type in or paste into the box. Having students scan a QR code with their devices to access a website you are using in class is super easy. You can make the QR code larger or smaller using the plus and minus buttons in the top left corner. The next widget is for drawing on the entire screen. Once you select this widget, your entire background will be covered by a white drawing box with various tools on the side for the size and color of the pen. You can draw in the box with your mouse, or if you have a smart board or Promethean board, you can draw right on the screen using your finger or the pen that goes with your board. You can also change the background of the drawing screen to lined paper or grid paper or even staff paper for music teachers. You can use the drawing feature to model handwriting or work through math problems and plenty of other drawing or writing activities as well. The next widget is just a smaller version of the drawing box, which will only take up some of your screen instead of the entire thing. With the smaller drawing box, you can actually upload images into the box and then draw over top of them. For example, if I was working on comparing fractions in math, I could upload an image of different fraction bar models and then use the drawing tools to shade in the fractions to compare them. You could also upload an image of a writing sample and then edit it using the drawing tools. Similar to the QR code, you can increase or decrease the size by clicking the plus and minus buttons in the top left corner, and you can click and drag the widget around the screen. You can also stack the small drawing box on top of the drawing background, so you could display a background such as the grid paper, and then have the smaller drawing box on top to use to work through additional problems. The next widget is the text box, which allows you to type or copy and paste text from somewhere else on your computer. My favorite way to use the text box is listing directions for students or displaying other important information. You have some basic text tools to customize the text, such as bold, italics, underline, numbered lists, bulleted lists, text alignment, smileys, text size, and text color. You can insert a horizontal line, which is a great way to split up your text, and you can change the background color of the text to highlight important parts. Again, you can adjust the size of the text box and you can move it around on your screen. You can also add an additional text box, so you could give different directions to different groups. Or you could have one display the current directions and another one display reminders or what to do when students finish. The next widget has a collection of work symbols, including silence, whisper, ask a neighbor, and work together. This is a great way to communicate with students your expectations for an activity. And again, you can add another one on the screen so you could differentiate for different group activities. The next widget is the traffic light, which allows you to choose between red, yellow, and green. You can use this to signal your availability. So if you are meeting with students and shouldn't be bothered, you could display the color red. You can also use this to remind students about the appropriate voice level if you can't use the sound level widget with a microphone. Red would mean no talking, yellow would mean whispering, and green would mean students can talk at a normal volume. Again, you can drag it around on your screen and you can add an additional traffic light to your screen. The next widget is a timer, which is one of my favorite tools. You can set the number of minutes and seconds, and you can choose the sound for when the timer ends. You can also make the timer loop, which means it will start over once it ends by adjusting the smaller number on the right side. This is great for stations because you don't have to go to the board and reset the timer for each rotation. If you would prefer to have a standard timer instead of a countdown timer, you have that option as well. This could be a great way to time your students during transitions and have them try to beat their time. Again, you can have two different timers going at one time, which is super helpful for different groups. The final widget is a clock, which can be really useful to have displayed so you don't miss lunch or switching classes or subjects. You can choose between 12-hour and 24-hour time, and you can also display a calendar. Since you can add an additional widget, you could have one display the clock and the other display the calendar. The final part of this website that I wanted to cover are the three options on the right side. The first one is an exit poll, which will actually open a new tab in your browser. You can choose the poll choices on the left side, and you can customize the text. You could have your students walk by your screen and quickly cast their vote. This can be a great way to get quick formative assessment data about your students' level of understanding or their feelings about a particular topic. The second one hides your widgets at the bottom of the screen and will bring them back. The third one will enter you into full screen mode, which will help you maximize your space on the screen. You can then press escape on your keyboard to exit full screen mode. Now, the reason I absolutely love Classroom Screen, besides the fact that it is free, because that's a huge plus, is that I can display different widgets all at one time. For example, I can have the clock displayed in the top right corner so I don't lose track of time, and I can have directions for my students displayed in a text box on the left side. Then I can display the work symbols and a timer so that my students stay focused. I really hope that this tutorial was helpful for you. I would love to hear how you use Classroom Screen in your own classroom down in the comments, and I would love for you to share this video out with your teacher friends who would also enjoy this website. Please give it a thumbs up and go ahead and subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you do not miss any future videos. As always, thank you for watching. I love you all so much. Don't forget to put your positive pants on, and I will catch you in the next one.
Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end of this video and for supporting my YouTube channel. If you want to check out any of my older videos, you can use the two links right down here. If you want to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any future videos, you can use the link right up here. The links to all of my social media sites, my Teachers Pay Teacher store, my merchandise store, and my Amazon store are in the description box, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.